esteemed brother and sister judges, Justice V. Ram Kumar, former judge of this court, Sri C.P. Sudhakar Prasad, the then Advocate General, Sri Sunil Jacob Jose, the President of the Kerala High Court Advocates Association, Sri K.K. Ravindranath, the Additional Advocate General, Sri Manjari Sridhar Nair, Director General of Prosecution and the State Public Prosecutor, Sri Suresh Babu Thomas, Additional Director General of Prosecution and the Additional State Public Prosecutor, Sri P. Vijay Kumar, Assistant Solicitor General, Sri K. V. Sohan, State Attorney, Sri P. K. Ravindranath Menon, Senior Central Government Standing Council, Sri Gracious Kuriakos, President of Senior Advocates Association, Sri Madhi S. K. Devi, President of Kerala Federation of Women Lawyers, Law Officers of Central and State Governments, Sri Haripal, Registrar General, Sri P. G. Ajit Kumar, Registrar Subordinate Judiciary, and other registrars, Sri K. P. Sudhir, Director Kerala Judicial Academy, Sri P. K. Aravinda Babu, Secretary Kerala State Legal Services Authority, Sri Joni Sebastian, Director, Kerala State Mediation and Conciliation Center, members of the bar, staff of the institution, advocate clerks, print and electronics media, my classmates, my friends, dear brothers and sisters, first of all, I thank you for the love and affection and support given to me all these years in this institution. It was on the fine morning of Monday, 28th January 2013, I took my step into the courtyard of High Court of Kerala for swearing as a judge. I have spent nearly quarter century in the judiciary of this state and gained rich experience. I am glad to have this opportunity to say that I have discharged my duties without fear or favor, affection or ill will, while I was serving on different positions in judiciary. My parents were not lawyers, but I am the first person who obtained a law degree in my family. However, as a judge of the High Court, as a district and session judge, as secretary, Kerala Legislative Assembly, as an elected member of a district council, Pathanamthitta, and a district library council, Pathanamthitta, I preserved human values and social justice. I also remember with great gratitude all my teachers who taught the great morals of life in my school and college studies. I am indeed indebted to my senior advocate, Sri K.V. Shombula, who shaped my legal profession as a lawyer at Pathanamthitta. I express my gratitude to his honorable former Chief Justice Sri M. Paleer Pillai, Honorable Justice K.J. Thomas, Sri Honorable Justice K. Sridharan, Honorable Justice T.V. Ramakrishnan, and Honorable Justice K.G. Balakrishnan, who selected me as a member of the judiciary. I am obligated to Honorable Chief Justice Srimathi Manjula Chilu and the members of the Collegium who had chosen me as a judge of this High Court. Words are too insufficient that I cannot express the blessings of Almighty throughout my life, especially during my difficult days. It gives me immense pleasure to say one word about my mother, who sacrificed her life for her five children, molded my life and prompted me to join law degree in the year 1982. My father, late P.T. Divakaran, who served in the British Indian Army and in the Indian Army, was a great man who always stood by my mother and motivated me in my studies during my school and college days. At this moment, I feel the warmth of blessings of my father, like P.T. Divakaran, and my mother, K.K. Janaki, who nurtured me in the great values of life. I am proud of being born as an eldest son of my beloved parents in the village of Arangmala, which is famous for metal mirror and snake boat race conducted annually in River Pampa near the Lord Parsadi temple, whose blessings I believe are always with me. I believe that true end of official life of a judge is not knowledge but action. Knowledge has to be converted into wisdom, and wisdom takes us to our destiny through right action. In this contest, the verses of verses 47 in chapter 2 of Bhagavad Gita is relevant. Karmanya Vadhikaraste Ma Pareshu Kadachana. When Arjun was not willing to fight the epic war of Mahabharata, Lord Krishna explains to him to perform his duties. You have the right to perform your prescribed duties, but you are not entitled to the fruits of the action. Never consider yourself to the cause of the result of your activities, and never be attached to not doing your duty. In short, action is distinguishable characteristic of a greatness of a judge. Constitution demands each and every judge of this country for right action. Commitment of law and justice is not confined to the legal community. It extends to every human being, for there can be no harmonious living without law and order. Law is a special calling demanding high qualities of study, contemplation, and above all, a concern for justice. Indian Republic is comparatively young, but our legal process is expensive and slow and seems to be favor the halves. All the three organs of the state, legislature, executive and judiciary, should be the servants of the people and instruments for their good. But the common complaint against this institution is that they are not alacrities in protecting the welfare of the people. All the great movement of judicial reforms initiated by the legal community to make expeditious and inexpensive have not succeeded. All efforts to reduce accumulated arrears in our country also have not achieved its goal. Judges have to listen that laws are made for the common people, but people cannot be shaped and programmed to suit prevalent laws. Therefore, a constructive idea and work shall be offered by the judicial community to protect our great democracy and our people. When law reforms were introduced in this country, we saw the increase in resistance from the vested interest. Often lawyers have opposed simplification of law and dismantling of time-consuming and costly procedures. When we saw the resistance of the lawyer community, when legal services authority was introduced in the country, when Delhi government proposed to set up a permanent Lok Adalat in the capital, the lawyers in Delhi courts went on a day strike to protest against this decision. In respect of the amendment of CPC, the same protest was received from the lawyers nationwide. It is true that judicial reforms will not go far without reforms of legal profession, since the judiciary comprises the bar and the bench. The great legal luminaries of our country often made exhortation that law is not a profession, but it is a service. Beyond that, there is also a legal fiction that lawyers are the officers of the court. However, the reforms in legal profession is nowadays treated as a taboo. It is pertinent to note that the discussion on reducing arrears of pending cases in the courts of India is focused mainly on the need for financial autonomy for courts, large budget allocation, and creation of more posts of judges in proportion to population. No doubt, all these are important factors, but they are by themselves will not be able to make a difference unless holistic approach is taken on the facts which are responsible for delay, high litigation costs, harassment and frustration of litigation. Legal profession is a noble profession, and every pertaining to it is deemed to be divine. Dispensation of justice is claimed to be a divine and sacred duty. I can say that this is the only profession which it claims to be tested by divinity. Former Chief Justice of India, Justice A.S. Anand, reminded us that though our function is divine, the problem begins when we start thinking that we have become divine. Secularism has been declared by the Supreme Court as part of the basic structure of our constitution, but all imagery pertaining to judiciary is very much non-secular, as it seems from the reference to Goddess of Justice, Temple of Justice, etc. Every day in the morning, before courts begin the proceeding, it is customary for both judges and lawyers to bow, but not to each other, on the other hand, to the Goddess of Justice. As a citizen of India, I can say that this is the only temple worshipped by every citizen of the nation, including the ground of religion, race, caste, place of birth and creed. While addressing the basic issues facing the justice system, the helpless litigants are interested in getting their decisions on their case, whatever way the judges are addressed by his advocate. The role of media in matter pertaining to judiciary is getting great prominence. The print and electronics media has increased its network, and the commencement of new channels in the region and the regional and English languages created new challenges in the modern India. Now there is acute competition among the media group. The competition with TRP rating obsession, investigative reporting, stinch operations have brought qualitative changes for the rapid spread and penetration of print and electronics media. The traditional relationship between media and the judiciary is therefore questioned, which resulted in confrontation, misunderstanding and controversy between these two pillars of democracy. In order to avoid such controversies in the larger public interest and strengthening the framework of democracy, a fresh thinking is necessary. If stinch operations are undertaken with bona fide intention, exposing systematic deficiencies, wrongdoing and corruption, it would not be proper to have the media. Another trend taken by the media is non-publication of matters pertaining to public interest and health. The trial by media in important cases is the difficulty faced by the court. It is true that media attention and publicity in some cases lead to the people to pursue vigorously in certain cases. When there is public demand, the media should pursue such major cases, which is natural. Hence, a comprehensive guidance on the relationship between the media and judiciary in consultation with the press council and the representative of the electronic media is necessary. Before parting, I must acknowledge the valuable service and support rendered by Sri Haripal, Registrar General of this High Court, and other registrars and former registrars, generals, and Sri Jagadish and Sri Anil Kumar. I would like to express my thanks to Sri Shahjuke Varghese, the security officer at this moment. I wholeheartedly thank the service rendered by Public Relations Officer T.S. Arun and his team, the Protocol Officer Sri R. Ashok and his team, the former Protocol Officer Sri Kumar and Assistant Protocol Officer Sri Neelakandan, the Librarian Srimati Deepa and her team, former Librarian Sri Rajmohan, Sri Anil T.S., Section Officer, Recruitment Cell, and Sri V. Krishnaraj, Assistant Accounts Officer, Assistant Accounts Section, are also rendered good service to me. At this moment, I remember the valuable service of Sri Kumar, Electrical Wing, and his team, Sri Srinivas, the Vehicle Superintendent, and his staff. Of course, the encouraging and honest support received from my personal staff during my tenure here is especially notable. First, I have thanked my private secretary, Srimati Lekhaji Krishnan, who has been a great support to me in discharging my duties as a judge of this High Court. To my knowledge and belief, she has honestly and faithfully discharged her duties as a team leader of my personal staff. My memories will always be filled with the great support and help received from other personal staff, Srimati Sajina K, Court Officer, Srimati Nisha S, PA 2J, Srimati Neelu AK, PA 2J, Bisna NG, PA 2J, Sri C. N. Unnikrishnan, Office Attendant, Sri Amir VA, Office Attendant, Sri Anil Prasadam, Office Attendant, Sri K. Harinarayanan, Bhauji is attendant, Srimati Sindhu AIR, part-time sweeper, Sri Vinod Kumarti, chauffeur, grade 1, Sri Srijitkam, PSO, Sri Arun Kumar B, PSO, Sri Shamir Gardner. They were dependable, supportive, encouraging and honest during their service with me. I thank them for all the support and goodwill shown to me over these years. I also thank the service rendered by Srimati Deepa AC, PA to Jet, Srimati Surekha, Court Officer, Srimati Subhita, PA, PA to Jet, Raji G, Office Attendant, and Sri Govan Gardner. I am glad to recall the service of the personal staff who have already retired from service, Srimati Sushma Kumari, Court Officer, Sri Paulus, Escort, Sri Hamsa, Chauffeur Grade 1, and Sri Mohan, PS to Jet. I remember with the gratitude the valuable services of Sri P.B. Babu Escort, who unfortunately escaped during August 2018. I cannot forget the most effective and encouraging support given to me by my wife, Dr. K. Valsala Kumari, when I felt insecure in my profession. When I shared my difficulties, she said, "Go ahead, I will be glad to keep the children. You only need to develop the talent God has given you." I say the above positive words encouraged me throughout my life. I would like to think that whatever success I have experienced brings her a great deal of satisfaction, knowing that she is largely responsible for my success. I remember the admiration and appreciation given by my sons, Dr. Indushekar R and Lishmi Narayan R, in my home. My family members, relatives, friends, classmates and well-wishers are present here. I thank them from the bottom of my heart for their strong support all these days. At this moment, I am proud to say that while I was holding jurisdiction of cases pertaining to criminal revision variations, I disposed of more than thousands of cases from the defect list which had been pending since 1998, and also thousands of motor accident claim cases in the last 2 years. I recall with gratitude the service of Sri Devarajan, former section officer of Criminal Revision Section. In order to reduce the pendency of huge number of motor accident cases, I put a beginning for settlement of cases through program compromise in my court. Majority of the lawyers cooperated for the same and a huge number of cases were settled. I thank them, the whole team for the offices and assistance in the criminal revision, petition and motor accident claim appeal section for their valuable services. 3 election petitions were also disposed by me during that period. Today, I bid farewell to this institution. The goodness, the victory, the glory and unfailing righteousness shown to you by me will surely be here. Such is my conviction. Thank you.